When I was growing up, I was most fascinated by science because it was kind of like magic. You had the dynamic of like me reading the Harry Potter series while I was learning the basics of science, and it seemed very similar. But then as I went into high school, it seemed like a discipline that could really change the world and help humanity fundamentally. It was a very big deal for my family for me to go to Caltech. I was the first person to go to college. We were going through the finances, and it would be very difficult for us to pay for even like a year of schooling. My father took a second job, and if worse came to worse, I would, you know, try and work my way through university. So when I found out that I got into Caltech and that a scholarship would pay for all of my 4 years, I did scream a lot. By the time I told my mom, she was crying. She was so happy. I was really excited. The academics at Caltech are, of course, known to be pretty rigorous. Around the third week, we were getting back all of our physics quizzes, and there was one that I kind of didn't really do too well on, and I started to question whether or not, you know, science was the right path for me and if I was even good at it. I had a TA who happened to be unparalleled in the field. His name was Dr. Frautschi.
I am a professor of theoretical physics.
We got together at his office, and he went step by step into the logic of how the questions were supposed to go and where my logic differed. He's really able to get into depth into the way a physicist would think.
In research, you're trying to do something new, so of course it isn't going to go the way you expect every time. And if you don't try things that may fail, you're never going to make much of a step forward.
Dr. Frautschi really taught me that the world's greatest scientists don't just know science like magically in their brain, but they really work towards understanding. I started to see myself more as a scientist and less as a student. I major in both bioengineering and business economics and management. I was also participating in research every summer. I worked for a Nobel laureate named Dr. David Baltimore, but I've also done a lot on campus. The manager of the women's basketball team, the Title IX committee. Last year I was awarded the Dean's Cup. You actually get a little glass. One of the committees that I was on as a sophomore was to award the Richard P. Feynman Teaching Prize, which happened to go to Dr. Frautschi that year, just saying. My graduation is coming up.
I will be very, very, very proud of her. This school has set her up for her future. It's just been an amazing, amazing, amazing ride.
It's just making me cry too. I'm going to graduate school to learn more about my field and to be able to do more research. And I was awarded a Marshall Scholarship for postgraduate study in the UK, which I'm really excited about. Caltech makes a difference, I think, in everyone's lives, from the big kind of scientific breakthroughs that go on, all the way down to even fostering, you know, undergraduates like myself in innovative science thinking. You're always looking forward to what's next and being able to question and wonder about the world.